Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Ori and the Blind Forest. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we made our way down Mount Horu and managed to block up one half of the cavern, which is spewing lava all over the damn place. And today, we're going to try and unblock the other half and see how that affects the forest and hopefully restore quote-unquote life to Nibel. So, let's get stuck into the game. And I think that must mean we've got one more room to do then. Just this one over here to the right. Have I got everything in this place? Looking like it. Just everything in the room on the right, and then we should be okay. Alright. I've really enjoyed this zone so far. I love the idea of going to these rooms and you've got different platforming puzzles requiring different degrees of skill with timing and stuff. It's actually been really fresh, I think, to an extent. So I'm really pleased with this zone actually. Don't get me wrong, I think the weakest one for me is the Forlorn Ruins. I just didn't really buy into the zone as a whole, to be honest. I don't know, it just didn't do anything for me. The Ginsochi was fantastic because it made you essentially use everything you'd already learned up until that point. And this one is definitely doing that as well. It just seemed that the Forlorn Ruins was kind of, no way, introduced that like nice element of the nice element of gravity, but to me that just didn't do much for me, if I'm being honest. Would you get out of town, man? These bloody things have been the bane of my life. Taper's Bane is what we're gonna call them. Thank you. I just need to get up here, friend. And then down one and to the right. Bloody hell. Right, I'll make one final save and then make our way through this zone on the right. Oh boy. Well, at least I can get that thing. Well, I'm supposed to go up there to the right, I see. Nope. I'm supposed to do some sort of clever jump just on this one to the right. Well, that gets me over here. We'll make another quick save. Well, the save functionality kind of breaks some elements of this game. Can I pull this thing? Oh, am I supposed to be trying to get this up? Grab it then. There we go. Supposed to get this thing up and to the right, yes. Oh, that's so it settles, that gets me under here. And then where does that get me? It gets me to the lever. Alright, let me just get this way. Oh, and then what I'm supposed to do is, because what's going to happen here, if I do this, I'm going to launch myself into the... into that thing. Okay, so I got it on there now. Just took a bit more effort than I was expecting. Oh, you've got to juggle it. There we go. And that's got me up there, so What I'll do is I'll just head on over here. Oh, don't you get in the way, you big bloody jerk. Shooting all your little children at me. I definitely want that thing, though. I'm not entirely certain how to get it at this moment in time, but I've never been able to screw myself this way before. God forbid, I'm not saving. I'm going to have to die here. God damn it, man. That was so unfortunate. Alright, let's not mess about with that. Let's just get this room out of the way before we think about going back and collecting that thing. Because what I think is going to happen is when I complete this room, these things will switch off anyway. And if they don't, they don't. I mean, it might just be testing my short mom memory to make sure I go back and actually collect the damn thing. No, it doesn't, which is fine. Well, how on earth does it want me to get this thing then? There we go. You're supposed to just try and hold it in place. Perfect. Okay. So that's that shit out of the way. Let's just make a quick save so we don't have to collect that thing again. And then make our way to the bottom of this place now that we've unlocked everything. Right. So now we need to go down to the bottom and the right just to collect that fight. There's something I'm missing in this right zone. I need to go get it. Oh, it's just this thing down here that was sat in the lava. Perfect. Let's get out of here before that thing tortures me. Make another save to get some health back, and then we'll just glide straight down to the bottom here. Yeah, just destroy those things, get this thing, and then I'd like to make a save, if at all possible. And that restores everything back to full, which are already full anyway, because I just got an ability point. Cool. So the final thing, the final thing I need to do in Mount Horu is get that thing, is get the ability thing down to the bottom. I keep calling them things. I apologize. I'm annoying myself by calling them things. They're not just things. Like, they're called something in the game. It's sort of like, okay, I need to just, all right. Wow, those things hit like trucks. There we go. Trick with that guy is to destroy these spitters on the right before you do the battle. Then you can just sort of stick to one side and not have to worry about these jerk-offs. But I want to kill them anyway, just out of spite. I'm not going to kill him just out of spite because he just killed me. Right, anyway, let's get down here. So there's something here to the right, so that's the direction I definitely want to be going first. Oh boy, that's hot. Is this guy here? Okay, so cool, we got that. So we can go to the left now, and I assume it's just gonna be another one of those trees. I don't know why there'd be a tree in this place. Oh, this looks ominous. And there's no map to this place at all.
The element of warmth is within our grasp. With the elements restored, we could undo the effects of her wrath.
Get ready for another escape sequence. had a feeling she'd rock up, you know. Alright, so I've got to sort of keep going at that point. Good grief. Ori, stomp! You've got no problem stomping when I don't need you to. Ori, my God. Oh boy! Ah, that was intense! She left them to burn. Thought she vanquished my light.
Ori, please get up! Spirit tree, so close. He's our only hope left.
Oh God! Please tell me the entire forest is not on fire now, because that'll be very bad news bears. Right, coolio. Oh, it's a story. I can't access any of the menus.
The spirit tree is near. There's one step more to take. The Forest of Nibel will live once again.
Yeah, the Forest of Nibel will keep killing this bird's children. Interesting though, Haru here has black feathers, so does Haru have get killed by light as well? Or it's clearly Haru is not a creature of light, otherwise this bird would be tearing it to pieces. Oh no. Am I supposed to feel warm and happy about this? Because I just don't, man. If anything, this game's just sort of show me how brutal nature can be sometimes. Like, some elements of nature need to destroy other elements in order to survive. In essence. Yes, the forest is restored, but that poor bird and a baby is had to sort of die for it, you know? Such a somber ending. Oh, the save the egg. From death comes life and all that. Man. And that's Ori and the Blind Forest, and I've got a few opinions based on this game, but all in all, I think this was a very splendid game to play. I thoroughly enjoyed it, and I think there wasn't really going for really cutting-edge gameplay or anything. There seemed to be going for more of a storytelling cinematic quality, and I think they did hit that nail on the head. As I was playing through the game and crumbs of the story were unveiled, I felt I wasn't getting filled with this feeling of happiness. Like, the end of the game there, I wasn't happy at all. Like, it was just showing the cruelty of Mother Nature, in that in some elements you've got creatures on the world which are harmed by other elements of nature. So unfortunately, Kuro's race was being harmed by the light, I suppose, in it were, and her children had to die for it, and that's what induced her rage and caused her to destroy the entire forest. And I don't blame her for being angry. I'd be pissed off if I lost my children, to be honest. Towards the end there, she got reminded of what it is to be a mother and look after children, and that's what made her sacrifice herself at the end of the day to bring life back to the forest. And it was a very somber, happy, sad ending, if you ask me. And gameplay wise I enjoyed it. One of my colleagues at work sort of have this idea that as you get to the Ginso tree, the game sort of peaks there and it doesn't really match it. And I agree, because the Ginso tree have a whole element of you put everything you learn together, you had one really intense chase sequence to this sort of music, actually. And what happened is it altered the entire world. So once that happened, the waters were cleaned. You could swim around in the world. And they tried doing that with the... I don't know if they've done it with Mount Horu, because obviously I've not been put back into the game yet. But they tried having elements of that with the Forlorn Ruins, in that you can now backtrack and go get certain pickups by using winds to propel you using Kuro's feather. But it wasn't as prevalent to me. Like, once you got out of the Ginso tree, you have this whole reprieve area, which is really peaceful, and you could swim around, try out a new ability. I just wish there was more of that with the Forlorn Ruins, where... I know they have a huge vertical zone with the winds there, but just some place where there was, like, next to no enemies, where you could play about, fly about, maybe get up to some certain platforms and learn how it works before you proceed onto a different zone. And for me, that would have probably made it a bit more prevalent, that by restoring certain elements of the forest, you're unlocking certain areas of the game. And I assume once I get dumped back into the game, there's going to be no fire around Mount Horu. And this is another thing that's disappointed me. I've ended the game, but I've not collected everything. And to me, I'd like to have the ability to... Because I was missing two abilities, which I assume I'm going to get once the game closes. I would like to have effectively got everything before I did the final sequence to feel like I've completely grown. Now that I've completed the game, I just don't feel the need to go back and collect anything, other than from a completionist point of view. And I'm not going to waste any more time in the Let's Play going back and collecting things, because I think I've done enough of that already. I'd like the Let's Play to end at the end of the story, you know. But all in all, the cinematic quality, the controls of this game were fantastic. They were very smooth, bit clunky in places, but all in all, that didn't really bother me too much. Like, needing to move projectiles in certain areas and then have the stomp ability on the analog stick, that just didn't seem right to me. It should have been on one of the other buttons. The controls are very smooth, particularly during sequences where you could tell it was very well designed. Like the final chase sequence once you're running away from Kuro after Mount Horu, that was fantastic, because you could really feel how smooth Ori was with jumping and climbing walls, and it was actually a really pleasure to play compared to some of the more clunky Metroidvania-esque style games. And yeah, all in all, I think this game was fantastic. I can see why it's got acclaim and why a lot of people like it. Just to certain elements, particularly the Forlorn Ruins, really unsold me. I just didn't buy into that zone at all. It made me more frustrated, if anything. It might have been my frame of mind going into it or something, but I don't know. After the Ginso tree, I expected it to be a bit more. And you know my main complaint about this game is just the variety of enemies. Like, it's just same shit, different zone. Like, that one bloody enemy which left shit lying around on the floor. It was just everywhere. I wish they had a bit of variety and give each of the zones a bit more of a personality in that regard. Like, don't get me wrong, Forlorn Ruins is ice, Mount Horu's fire, the Ginso tree's water, and so on and so forth. I just wish that the enemies also changed to match, not just have an icy blob instead of a fire blob. I think that would have put the game another step above, if you ask me. But that's neither here nor there. That's just a minor complaint. And I think this game was fantastic, and I thoroughly enjoyed playing it. I'd love to do another sort of 2D platforming game as well, with these collectathon element, because they're just really fantastic to play. And to an extent, not so much to Let's Play, because there are elements where I need to focus, which means I'll probably go like 10 minutes without saying anything. But that's just the nature of focusing in video games in general. Anyway, I'll stop holding all your time up now and finally get this Let's Play ended off. Apologies I've not gone back and collected everything, because I want the game to end on that note, to be honest. So, thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next series.